Live from Studio 5 on Michigan Avenue, this is NBC 5 News Today at 6 a.m.
We'll talk to a vet to learn how much is too much. There's a dog wearing sunglasses in our studio this morning, and she doesn't seem to mind. Is that a she, Tony? I'm guessing by the pink shirt she's also wearing. We'll talk about that coming up next. Welcome back. How do you know if your pet is overweight? Joining us this morning, Dr. Tony Kramer. Good to see you.
Good morning.
She can't be overweight.
Well, she has had the battle of the bulls before.
Yeah?
Yeah, she scopes up the cat food when they don't finish it. But she's here to tell us that living large isn't all about fancy clothes and a little bit of bling bling.
It looks like it is. Her shirt says Drama Queen on it. Just adorable. You were talking to me in the commercial about overweight pets. An alarming percentage of pets are overweight.
It's true. When we talk about living large, we're talking about the pet's body size being too large.
Right.
And so many of them nowadays are, you know, carrying those extra pounds. And it's something that basically, yes, we're killing the pets with kindness. There's so many medical problems that are associated with being overweight. In large dogs, we see so many things like joint problems, arthritis. In small dogs, intervertebral disc disease, even paralysis.
Yeah.
In cats, the incidence of diabetes is staggering in an overweight cat versus a thin cat.
How do you know? Because it seems like it's tough to tell with little dogs or certain dogs whether they're overweight or
not. There are all kinds of charts and tables that will try to help you figure out if your pet's overweight, but it's all about kind of being simple.
Right.
When your pet's not wearing clothes.
Which is most of the time for people, I think.
Run your hands along their sides. We want to feel their ribs without seeing the ribs.
Mm-hmm.
And we know they're at the right conformation. Mm-hmm. If we run our hands along and it's nice and smooth, we've got some weight to lose.
That's pretty rare. This is an actual, that's gross.
And the first thing in the morning, when you think about this is a pound of fat, or represents a pound of fat anyway, and you think about that on a small dog like this, that's very considerable.
And so one thing, once you would determine if your pet's overweight, I would think these are some of the things you can feed them to help control that.
Exactly. A couple of tips are to know how much you're feeding the pet. You know, when people say they feed a cup of food or a scoop of food, what are they talking about? Have an exact measurement so we can make adjustments.
Yeah.
And if you really struggle with getting the weight off your dog, a veterinary prescription diet is going to make the process a lot easier.
Some people just dump that bag out.
Yeah,
don't measure it.
Exactly.
Good to see you.
Thanks for having me.
Thanks to the Drama Queen. And, I mean, even the collar, Anita, is styling and profiling. Pat Lake is very jealous because his dog is up in the control room right now. Will you bring it over maybe for the end of the show, Pat? Can I put you on the spot?
I'm hoping my dad watched this segment because he's always throwing scraps to my old dog.
A lot of people do that.
He doesn't need any more of that junk.
Yeah.
All right. Well, thank you very much, Rob. It's 627.